Hey everyone. In this video, we're going to walk through solving a problem using the bisection method in Google Sheets. So, our problem states to find the rightmost root of the following function using the bisection method to an error level of 0.05. Our function here is 4x squared plus 3x minus 3. Just a quick note, if you missed our previous video on the theory behind the bisection method, I will leave a link in the description below for you to check out first. Just remember that the bisection method is used for finding the roots of a nonlinear equation. So, to begin, let's just create some headers for our table. Let's assume that A is always going to be our lower boundary input value, and B is going to be our higher boundary input value. C is going to be our midpoint value, which will be found based off our A and B values. F of A, F of B, and F of C will be found using the function roots that we are solving for. Next, we need a column that determines which of the two inputs, f of a times f of c, and f of b times f of c, gives a negative value, and this will tell us which direction we need to move, whether that be left or right. Then, lastly, we just need to calculate the error at any given iteration, which is simply our higher boundary input b minus our lower boundary a. For this first iteration, we need to assign A and B values based on what we found in our positive or negative product test that we performed in the previous iteration. So, to accomplish this, we're going to use a simple if statement. So, to do so, we type equals if and then a logical statement, so that means something that will either be true or false. So, we select the value given by f of A times f of C and test if that is less than zero. If true, that means our root is to the left of our midpoint, and A will remain unchanged, whereas B will take on the midpoint's value. If false, then the root is to the right of the midpoint, and A will take on midpoint C's value. We repeat the same formula for our higher root boundary, B. Now, we are free to bring down all of the rows. Every time we create a new row like this, we are basically iterating another step, much like we did in the previous video, except this method is much faster. As you can see, after only 5 iterations, our error term is lower than our acceptable value, which means that we are done. We could also visually depict our function and the boundaries in the following way. Create small steps in the x direction, let's say 0.01, and we will go from our initial bounds of 0 to 1. Then, beside this, we can apply these inputs to our function and get the outputs. Next, we can graph the function and visually see that we do indeed have a root between these two points, 0 and 1. Next, I'm just going to add in a vertical line here at our iteration 5x value. This is just to visualize where we're actually at. So, we have just completed a problem using the bisection method in Google Sheets. One additional thing that is cool to add is a validation that we indeed have a root between our two boundaries. So, to accomplish this, let's create an if or statement which states that if f of a times f of c or f of b times f of c, and just note the syntax here, is less than 0, we print true, there is at least one root present. Or if it is false, we print that. The only time this could give you trouble is if you have more than one root present within your boundaries. And you can ensure this doesn't happen simply by graphing the function like we did earlier. So, just a final note here, you can really use this Google Sheet you just created to solve for any function you want using the bisection method. All you need to do is adjust the formula here for f of a and copy and paste that into f of b, f of c, and f of x for iteration 0 and 1 here. Copy and pasting works here in this formula as our input term is always just to the left of the cell that we're solving for, which is the output for that given input. Then, lastly, you just adjust your boundaries a and b to contain a single root within them. This may take some adjusting, but can easily be done through plotting the function like we did on the right here. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of how we solve for the root of a function through the bisection method using Google Sheets. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships or our Patreon down below to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.